Hi guys and welcome to International Aesthetics. We've been receiving a lot of your questions regarding different topics, and we've decided to cover one single topic in each video so that everyone can benefit from those. The topic we're going to cover today is supplements. Supplement India has a huge myth regarding supplements. Supplements are nothing, just simple food products that supplement your diet, complete your diet. You cannot get all the things from your diet, all the most essential amino acids. So supplements aid you, help you through that process. But a lot of people in India have many misconceptions about supplements. So in this video, we are gonna try and clear most of them. There's always been questions regarding supplements on our page. So some of them are, do I must take supplements to build my body? No, supplements are not at all most important to build your body. The most important thing to build your body is your diet. Your diet is the most foremost thing to build your body. If you're not taking a good diet and you're only taking your supplements, then you cannot achieve your goal. Supplements just aid you through the process to reach your goal in a more effective manner, but diet is the most important thing. Are supplements are more important than diet? No, not at all. As I said, the four most important thing is your diet. If you're not taking your good diet and you're completely relying on supplements and you're ignoring your balanced diet, your minerals and vitamins and all, you're gonna face consequences when you grow old. Like some people face joint pain, weakening of bones and etc. You're not building your body, you're weakening it from inside if you're completely relying on supplements and not having a balanced diet. So yeah, supplements are good, they are useful, but there's a reason that why they are called supplements. Main diet is the most important thing. When do I know I'm ready for supplements? Well, there's no fixed time that when you're ready for supplements or not. It's just a food intake. When you can start taking it from any time, but we would consider to go for a balanced diet, to develop a habit of a good balanced diet with enough macros and nutrients in it so that you can achieve your goals, and then add supplements so that you can achieve your goal most effectively. Some people go from a very low calorie diet, they take a hardcore gainer, go to a very high calorie diet. When their gainer finishes off, they come back to the low calorie diet and all their gains are lost. So that's how it's happened. You should always try and maintain your calorie intake. The muscle gain and loss is all completely depends on your calorie intake. Question: which supplement should I take? Well, so there are a lot of supplements in the market. There are BCAAs, creatine, glutamine, pre-workouts, beta-alanine, and everything. There are so many supplements in the market. So it completely depends upon your goals. But the one supplement that is universal for all is, I guess, a good amino profile whey protein, because whey protein helps you lose fat as well as gain muscle. And it's also highly unlikely to go home after every workout and take a good high protein diet, as your body is exhausted and needs amino acids and protein to replenish. So there comes the need of a handy protein shake. Does supplements have any risk? No, that, as I said, supplements have many myths and misconceptions in our country. Supplements don't have any risk at all. It's just a food intake. You're taking, you're digesting it, and your body's building from that. It's not you're injecting something. You're not playing with the genetics. You're not taking anything oral and oral drugs or anything. It's you're eating your amino acids and your macros, everything from in a packed food. You know how much you're eating, so it has no complications, I guess. But the only two complications I know are with creatine. What creatine does, it takes water from your bloodstream and it stores the water in your muscle tissues so that your muscles look bloated and bigger. But in this process, creatine takes water even from your electrolytes in your blood. So electrolytes become more concentrated and they can get concentrated inside your kidney and can form a stone. And the other probable side effect would be of whey protein. If you're on a high protein diet, you're on too much of meat and you're having a lot of liquor, on top of that you're adding whey, then you might face the problem of uric acid. But that's also highly unlikely. If you take enough amount of water, at least 4 to 5 liters in a day, both the problems will be away from you. After leaving supplements, will I go back to the normal body size? Well, this is, as I said, another taboo in India, that people think that after leaving supplements they go back, these bodies are not natural. As I said, the size, the muscle gain, it all depends upon your calorie intake. You go to a high calorie intake, you will gain mass. If you go to a low calorie intake, you will lose mass. So it all depends on your calorie intake. Supplements just aid you, help you reach that calorie level. It's up to you to maintain that calorie level, or you can go back to that calorie level. These are the only questions we have right now. If in future, if you have any other questions, feel free to ask, and thanks for your support.